Good morning, students. In this video, I am going to talk about the shapes you are observed in your day-to-day life. The shapes are rounded. Can you list out those? For example, bicycle wheel, bullet cart wheel, wall clock, triangle. You observe many more things like this shape. They are called circles. Do you know about the circles? In the lower classes, you learn about the circles. But in this second year, we are going to know the uses of circles. What are the applications of circles? And what are the equation of circle and its tangents and many more in this class. Okay, let us start now. Definition of circle mathematically. Okay. The path of a points, the path of points which are equidistant from a constant point, path of a point, points which are equidistant, equidistance from a fixed point is called a circle. This fixed point, let us say some C. This C is called the center of the circle. The fixed point is center of circle, and the fixed distance, let us say this one, either the point P is here or anywhere. Okay, the point P is variable. Right, it varies at anywhere. The fixed distance from the center to the point is called the radius. Okay. Now the radius means the distance of this one. The length of CP is called radius. Now we are going to learn about the application of circles in the daily life. It is an important branch of geometry. Okay, the circle is important branch of geometry. Let us see the application of this circles in the daily life. Okay, watch this.
equation of circle. Okay, you are defined that the circle is the locus of the points which are equidistant from the fixed point, that you know. Suppose in the plane I take the center of the circle is 0, 0, 0, 0, say C. C is the center of circle and P is any point on the circle, on the circumference of circle. This P is at anywhere, that is X, Y. Generally you say X, Y. XY is a point on the circumference of the circle. Okay, you know that if P is here, here, here or anywhere, that CP is constant. That CP is constant. That is called the radius, that is equivalent to R, I say. Okay. Now CP is equal to R, you know that. Why? Because radius is positive only. Okay, you know that. The distance between CP is the radius. That is, you know that the distance between two points is x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square under root. That's why this is CP square is equal to R square, then R x minus 0 whole square plus y minus 0 whole square is equal to R square. That is x square plus y square is equal to R square is called the standard form of the circle. Standard form of the circle. If the center not lies at the origin, suppose I take the center is H, K. H, K is my center, and then P is any point, P is any point on the circumference of the circle. Then if center not lies at origin, let us say the center is H, K and the radius is R, then the equation of circle is x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square is equal to r square. X minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square is equal to r square. Okay, this is r. Right. Then what is the general form of a circle? The general form of the circle you know that in the pair of straight lines you learned about the general form of the equation, curve equation is ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. General form of the circle, general form of the circle, you know that already the general equation is ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. In the first year it is about the pair of straight lines general equation. In that we say that suppose a is equal to b, and H is equal to 0, A is equal to B but not equal to 0, that means it is a quadratic equation and a order 2 degree, second degree equation, okay. And also xy term is absent, then it is called a equation of the circle. See here, x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0 is called the general form of circle with center minus g comma minus f and radius g square plus f square minus c, and the radius under root of g square plus f square minus c. Let us see how it is. You observe here ax square plus 2hxy plus by square, in that here xy term is absent and x square coefficient is 1, y square is coefficient is 1, that's why a is equal to b, and x square y square terms are present, that's why a b not equal to 0, okay. Only x terms, y terms and x square y square and a constant is there, okay. Now this radius, you remember that always it is positive, that's why g square plus f square minus c is greater than or equal to 0. It is must and should, g square plus f square minus c is greater than or equal to 0. How you can find this? Suppose here the center is minus g minus f, okay, and xy is any point on the circle, then c is equal to minus g minus f and p is xy, then the equation is in the previous cp is equal to r, like that here x minus h is here minus g and k is minus f, that's why it is x plus g whole square plus y plus f whole square is equal to r square. Now x square plus 2gx plus g square, by expansion of this you get x square plus 2gx plus g square plus y square plus 2fy plus f square is equal to r square. Now you can write it as x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus g square plus f square minus r square is equal to 0. Compare with general equation you observe that g square plus f square minus r square is equal to c. From this, g square plus f square minus c is equal to r square. That's why r is equal to under root g square plus f square minus c. Okay, we understand this, I think. Okay. Now, let us do one problem on this. Hmm. Find the equation of circle origin as its center and radius is 3 units. How you can write here this? You observe this. This is the standard form of a circle. What is the standard form of the circle equation? That is x square plus y square is equal to r square. The standard form is x square plus y square is equal to r square. Here r is 3 units. That's why this is the equation x square plus y square is equal to what is 3 square? That is 9 only. So this is the equation per circle. Okay, let us do another problem. Write the equation of circle with radius 5 units and having center -2, 3. Which formula you can use? Now here the center is not at the origin. The center is somewhere at another. Okay, then you can use this formula. X minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square is equal to r square. X minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square is equal to r square. Here in this you observe that the h is -2 and k is 3. So it is x plus 2 whole square. You observe that h is equal to -2, then minus h is minus or minus plus. Plus 2 plus y minus 3 whole square is equal to 5 square. That you observe that x square plus y square plus 4x minus 6y plus 4 and plus 9, 13 plus 13 minus 25 is equal to 0. This is x square plus y square plus 4x minus 6y minus 12 is equal to 0. Okay. You understand this? Then take another one. Find the center and radius of a circle two x square plus 2y square minus 8x plus 9y plus 4 is equal to 0. Students, look here. The equation is not like that x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. It is the x square coefficient is 2 and y square coefficient is 2. Here you observe the property a is equal to b. A is equal to b is satisfied. Here xy term is not there. So it is a equation of the circle. So you make it as the general equation. Make it first as a general equation. Then what you get? Given equation is 2x square plus 2y square minus 8x plus 9y plus 4 is equal to 0. Convert it into the general form x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0 form. Then you get x square plus y square divided with 2. To make the x square y square coefficient is 1. Okay, x square plus y square minus 4x plus 9 by 2 into y plus 2 is equal to 0. Okay, now you compare with the general form and you get the center and the radius. The general form is what? General form is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. By comparing, you observe that 2g is equal to minus 4. This implies g is equal to minus 2. And 2f is equal to 9 by 2. That implies f is equal to 9 by 4. And c is equal to 2. From this, center is equal to minus g comma minus f, what you learned in the previous. Center is equal to 2 comma minus 9 by 4. Okay, then the radius is equal to square root of g square plus f square minus c. That is equal to, what is g square? That is 4 plus f square is 81 by 16 minus c is 2. That is under root of 81 by 16 plus 2. 16 LCM, 81 plus 32, that is equal to 113 by 4. Under root 113 by 4 units. Okay, this is the radius. Okay, do you understand this? Now I am going to give you some problems as your work. Please do that and you test your knowledge. Okay, thank you.